Now here, interface means when you want to inherit two class at the same time, that was not possible in Java. We were getting error while inheriting two class, or it doesn't support in a Java to inherit two class with this extend keyword. So in order to implement that, the interface term was introduced and we were using the term implements. In place of extend, we use the term implements. Okay, so here, for example, let me show you these two class first, printable and showable. So here I create one interface. It is similar to that. Here you will not create any class here. Here you will going to create an interface. An interface, how you will going to create? It is similar to like this, new, and you can see here, in place of class, you have interface concept, right? So interface, why I'm using here? Because you can't inherit the class, so you have to create an interface to implement that, which is similar to the class only. So here, this interface, you have to use it in place of a class if you want to work with the multiple inheritance, if you want to implement two class at the same time, okay? If you want to implement two class at the same time, then you will going to implement, you have to call this implement keyword you have to use, right? So let me show you. I created one interface, and in that interface, I'm just calling one method. This method doesn't having any body, right? You can see this print method doesn't having any body. It means this print method is doing nothing. It's just an interface printable. It is having one method, print. Similarly, showable is one class. In this also, I created one. This is an interface, and it is also calling one method, show, and it doesn't having any body. Show is also doing nothing. Now, when you wanted to provide a body to it, for example, this two class, printable and showable, is window, suppose 7 or window 8, and exercise is your window 10. So when you're going to implement it, so how you're going to do that? Public class exercise, implement printable and showable. Now here you are going to use class because you are implementing two interface. I mean to say that you can implement two interface at the same time, but you can not extend two class at the same time. If you remember the multiple inheritance, the structure was like this. There were two class, so you cannot inherit this two class at the same time. This is not possible in class Java, okay? This two class you cannot inherit at the same time. That's the reason we introduced the term interface. So you create two interface, and then this class will go into implement this interface. I repeat once again, if all these three are class, then this is not supporting a Java. So you can create two interface and you can extend it in a class. So that is only I'm doing here. And when I'm implement this two interface, I will going to provide a body to it. You can see here, I'm using the function void show, which is present in a showable class, this one, and I'm providing a body to it. What body means? I provide a curly brace and I'm printing here hello message. Similarly, here also I provide a body and I'm printing a welcome message here. Now here, I created a main method, public static void main. I'm creating an object of which class? Exercise class. Why? Because my main method is present in this class, and now I will going to just call it. I will going to instantiate the method. So how you will going to instantiate exercise object means the way that you create an object is class name, object name, new keyword, then class name. So this object you have to call here, and then with this object we'll call print and show function. So as you call it, it will going to run. Now let me run and show you. So you can see here, it is printing the welcome and hello message. Why it is printing welcome first and hello later? Because based on the calling, I am calling first print function. So it will going to print welcome first. It is calling show, so it is calling hello now. So in this way, your interface work. Interface used in which scenario? Interface used in a scenario where you wanted to inherit two classes at the same time. For example, Windows 10 want to use Windows 7 and Windows 8, right? So that is not possible. So what you can do, you can create an interface, those two class, okay? As I did printable and showable interface, and exercise is my class that is inheriting this. So this is an example of interface. I hope it is clear to you. Any question here, any one of you? Anyone having any question? Okay, thank you, Vimesh. So now let's come to the collection part, a collection framework in our syllabus. What do you mean by this collection framework? A collection is in Java, it's one framework you can say, or inside this library. Can all of you mute yourself? Yeah, okay. So collection is a one framework, which means what? Collecting an element. You can say as a bucket where you are holding the element and you can manipulate them effectively. So collection is a framework introduced in a Java that can be act as a data structure where you can access an element in an efficient way. Okay. It means that similar to the array concept where you read the data and you manipulate it. But this, there is a difficulty in inserting and deleting the data in an array. So the array concept is introduced which make your task easier. Okay. So now here you can see here, I created one package collection and import java util.star is my library. Why I implement this? Because I am showing you an example of linked list. Okay. Linked list data structure. You might have heard that, one data structure in Java. In that linked list, how you can access an element, how you can add an element. In an array, if you want to add an element, you have to read. But linked list is what? You can add an element of any data type here. Okay, you can see here, I created a linked list collection, which is one of the collection. If you put the cursor, it can show you Java util dot linked list. And in that linked list, I am adding an element 1, 3, null, 7, 9, right? How you're going to add an element? It is similar to like an object that you have created, right? Linked list. Anu is a type of that linked list. New and linked list. Why do we use new keyword? New keyword is used so that we can provide a space to this all element inside the RAM. For object also, we use new keyword, right? When we create an object, why do we use new? So that the object will get space in the RAM, because object is holding the variable and all value, right? So here also, I'm telling you one collection, linked list, which is holding the string data. That's why I have taken in a double quotes, every value. So you are going to define data type here, integer, string, float, double. And once you call this add function, it will going to add in the list.
Now, once you add in the list, you can check it with the predefined function. Is this ano is empty or what? So it will going to tell you true and false. Now, in order to iterate over it, iterate means in order to do the iteration, you have to call iterator function in collection, iterator type string, name of a iterator here, and which linked list or a variable you want to iterate, anu.iterator. So iterator is one class of string type. This is the variable A. Anu is what your linked list, and you want to iterate over the anu. So now when you will write a for loop or while loop, while A dot has next, what it will going to do, it will going to check, does A is having any element? Okay, it will going to check this part, this iterator part. What is actually doing, this iterator part will be assigned with all the element that are present in a anu to this A. I repeat once again, just like in a for loop, I explain you the temporary variable will be assigned with all the element, right? So here also, this A will be assigned with all the element of anu. Now here you are checking, does anu has an element? Yes, anu has an element. This is true. You will come inside. You will going to print it A dot next. So if unless this A is having an element, once this all the element they get printed, then it will stop printing that. Let me run and show you. You can see here, this false is coming. Why? Because anu is not empty, right? Is anu is empty? No, because it is having element 1, 3, null, 7, 9, Amit, right? So this is not an empty. So here, 1, 3, null, 7, 9, and remember they will not going to follow any order, but they will going to save it in a collection. So it is 1, 3. If you want to follow any order, that also I will going to show you in my next class, some other collection type. But this is one example of collection where you can efficiently use the predefined function like add is empty iterator to delete an element. Deletion an element in an array is very difficult. Deletion and insertion of new element in a sorted order. But in the collection, you can do it very easily. So you can see all the element that I've added, it's printed here. Right? So in this way we work. Why do I add one Amit here, right? Do you know? Because I wanted to add Amit on index 1. You can see here 1. After 1, this is index I'm talking about, not a data, okay? This is index 1. This is index 0. Then index 1, I wanted to add Amit. So that's why it is coming Amit. Then index 2, 3. Index, this is null. So this way, we can access an element of collection. And collection is what? It's a storage, just like a bucket where you save a record. So I hope it is clear to you. Do you have any question, anyone of you?